NTSE and Olympiad questions. Today we will solve few questions from it. Children, we will try to solve 21 to 30. But in between, I will skip some questions because those are questions are very easy and you can do it by your own. So here I will explain you question number 21. Conduct the calculations as directed. You should get the same number at the end, which is at the starting. This point is very important. We have to conduct all the calculations marked here. Sometimes multiply, subtract, divide, addition, whatever is mentioned here. But we must get the same number at the end what we have at the starting. So here we have 10. So at the end, after completing all these calculations, we must get 10. So I have framed this question on a blank sheet and now we will begin as per the directions given. 10 multiplied by 5 is 50. 50 minus 20 is 30. 30 divided by 6 is 5. 5 plus 23 is 28. 28 minus 8 is 20. 20 minus 15 is 5. 5 multiplied by 10 is again 50. 50 divided by 5 is 10. So children, after conducting all the calculation, I got the same number at the last from which I have started. So this one is correct. As I have given you the example, same way we have to conduct all these calculations and we must ensure that we'll get number 4 at the end. So this is for you, this challenge for you. So please do it and send your work to me. So children, this is question number 22. Find the missing number. We have a circle and this circle is divided into many parts. But can we see in the middle? This is number 2. It gives us some indication to find this missing number. So if you will look at clockwise, the numbers are in decreasing order. But if you look anti-clockwise, the numbers are in increasing order. 2 multiplied by 2 is 4. 4 twos are 8. 8 twos are 16. 16 twos are 32. 32 twos are 64. So to get this question mark, this missing number, we will multiply 64 by 2. So 64 multiplied by 2, 4 twos are 8 and 2 six are 12. So answer is 128. Option number A is the correct answer. Now we will solve NTSC question number 24. What does flower minus teddy bear represents? Children, we know very well that it is very easy to subtract the numbers. But here the problem is given in the form of pictures. So first of all, we have to find the value of one flower and the value of one teddy bear to solve this sum. So here is the information given. The first information says one teddy bear and two flowers equals to 18. 1 teddy bear and 2 flowers equals to 18. 1 teddy bear plus 1 flower equals to 10. So as we can see in the second equation, 1 flower is missing. It means the value of this flower is not been added here. So let's find the value of this flower by subtracting 10 from 18. 18 minus 10 equals to 8. It means this value of this flower is 8. Now we have to find out the value of teddy bear. 1 flower and 1 teddy bear equals to 10. So if I will subtract the value of this flower from the total, I can get the value of teddy bear. So 10 minus this 8 equals to 2. It means the value of 1 teddy bear is 2 and value of 1 flower is 8. So now come back to the equation. The question says, what is the value of 1 flower minus 1 teddy bear? The value of 1 flower is 8 and value of 1 teddy bear is 2. So if I will subtract these two numbers, the answer will be 6. So option number A is correct. Question number 25. In the word Indian, what fraction of letters have curved lines? Children, we all are Indian and we are proud to be an Indian. Now, come to the letters which make word Indian. I, N, D, I, A and N. In a previous class, we have learned about the curved lines and the straight lines. So, I will tell you again. The sleeping line, standing line and slanting lines are known as straight lines. But any line which make curves, these lines are known as curved line. So look at this word and the letters. Letter I, N, I, A and N are made by only straight lines. But letter D has a curved line. So we got one information that only letter D, means only one letter, has curved line. Now we have to find the fraction. Fraction is a part of a whole. If something is divided into equal parts and we are talking about one part of it or two parts of it, it's known as a fraction. In next months we'll learn about this fraction, but I'll give you a short information about it. There are two parts of a fraction. The upper part is known as numerator and the lower part, the bottom part, is known as denominator. Denominator always talks about the total number of parts. In word Indian, the number of letters, the total number of letters, denotes denominator. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total number of letters in the word Indian is 6. So denominator will be 6. So option number A and B both can be true. Now we have to find the fraction of letters which have curved lines. So we can see easily that only letter D, only one letter has a curved line. So the numerator talks about the parts we are talking about. In this question, we are talking about curved lines. We are talking about the part which have curved lines. So in this word, only one part, only D, has a curved line. So numerator will be 1. Denominator means the total number of parts or total number of letters, and numerator means the part or the letter we are talking about. So here we are talking about only D, that is only 1. So the fraction will be 1 upon 6. So option number B is correct. Next question, question number 27. Priya travels 2422 km by an aeroplane and 1200 km by train. Garima travels 1200 km by aeroplane and 2422 km by train. Which of the following statements is correct? Garima has travelled more than Priya. Priya has travelled more than Garima, or both have travelled the same distance. So children, first we will write and we will try to find out the total distance travelled by Priya and Garima. So Priya, and here I will write about Garima. Priya has travelled 2422 km by aeroplane, then 1200 km by train. But Garima did opposite of it. She travelled 1200 km by aeroplane, then 2422 km by train. Children, if you remember, we have learned the properties of addition. In the properties of addition, we have learned about the order property of addition. The order property says, if you change the position of the numbers, of the same numbers, the sum remains same. The sum will not change. So if I will write 2422 first, then 1200, or we can write 1200 first, then 2422 later, the value and their sum will not change. Let's check it once again. So if I will sum these two numbers, I will get 2, 2, 6, 3, 3622. Now check it again. If we are changing the places of the numbers, whether the value will change or not. 0, 2, 2, 0, 2, 2. I see it is same. 4, 2, 6, and 2 and 1 is 3. Yes, we got the same sum. Both the side, the value is same. It means they both have traveled the same distance. Option number C is correct. Question number 29. Tanmay spent the amount of money shown below. Children, Tanmay went to the market to purchase some items, and he spent these money in the market. So let's see what he has spent. Rupees 500, rupees 100, rupees 100, rupees 50, and rupees 5. This is the money which Tanmay spent in the market. If Tanmay had rupees 1000 in the beginning, the total money Tanmay had in the beginning is rupees 1000. How much amount of money is left with him? Children, the money he had in the beginning, if we will subtract the amount he spent in the market, we can get the money left with him. This is simple subtraction sum, but before subtracting, we have to add to find the total amount spent by him. So rupees 500 plus 100 is 600, 700, 750, 755. So the money spent by him is money spent equals to rupees 5, 6, 750 and 5, 755. But Tanmay had rupees 1000 in the beginning. So total money he had at the beginning equals to rupees 1000. So we simply have to subtract these two numbers to get the money left with Tanmay. So today we have done in the subtraction chapter, 10 minus 5 will be 5 and this will become 9. 9 minus 5 is 4. This will also become 9. 9 minus 7 is 2. So 1 has already given to them. It is 0. So rupees 245 will be left with Tanmay. Now let's please check the options. Okay, option number B is correct. So children, first we have to add the money spent by Tanmay. Then we will subtract from the money he had to get the amount of money is left with him. The next question, question number 30. Mamta goes to the market with rupees 5000 and saw the following offers. Children, offers. Sometimes we go to the market and we find out that if you will get two, you will get one free. Okay, the offer says that sometimes you can get two items in together in the less price. So the same way, there were some offers in the market. So when Mamta goes to the market with 5,000 rupees, she also saw there were some offers. Which of the following offers she can take so that she spends the whole amount with her? She wants to spend the whole amount, 5,000 rupees. She doesn't want to keep something left with her, or she doesn't want to spend more money than 5,000 rupees. She wants the exact amount to be spent, that is rupees 5,000. So let's see what are the offers. The price of one t-shirt is rupees 1,800, purse rupees 3,200, clock rupees 4,000, and the teddy bear rupees 1,700. So there were four offers. Now let's calculate the amount of each offers. The first offer is t-shirt and purse. The cost of t-shirt is rupees 1,800 and purse is 3,200. Let's count it. So option number A, the total of option number A will be 1,800 plus 3,200. Option number B says purse and teddy bear. Purse 3,200 and teddy bear 1,700. 3,200, 1,700. Option number C, t-shirt and clock. T-shirt rupees 1,800 and clock rupees 4,000. 1,800 plus 4,000. Now option number D. Option number D says teddy bear and a clock. Clock cost rupees 4,000 and teddy bear 1,700. Then 4,000 will be added into it. Now let's add all these options together. So the first option, 0, 0, 0, carry over 1, 5,000. We got the exact amount, 5,000. The next one, 3,200 plus 1,700, 0, 0, 9 and 4. If she purchases purse and teddy bear, 100 rupees will be left with her. 0, 0, 8 and then 5. 800 rupees more she has to spend. 0, 0, 7 and 5. 700 more she has to spend. So option number A says rupees 5,000 she can spend if she purchases t-shirt and purse. So t-shirt and purse is the correct option.